So Pete's just, he's lighting it now. Oh, yeah.
So we've got a compartment that's been furnished like a standard room. We've just ignited it in the far corner as if a child's been playing with a sofa, playing on a sofa with a cigarette lighter, similar to several examples that I'll show you later on.
Smoke is coming out already.
Yeah, the foam produces an enormous amount of smoke very, very quickly, but that foam is also highly toxic. It contains hydrogen cyanide, hydrogen fluoride, hydrogen chloride gas, and so if you stand up in that, it's obviously is very toxic and you can be overcome. Yeah. Even if you're not overcome, it can affect your reasoning ability, and people do all sorts of unusual things. Might go and hide in a cupboard or do other things rather than make a safe escape. You can now see that flame with just a few seconds into it. We've now got actually flame extension across the ceiling. It's now heating up other items in that room. They will start to combust. It will be penetrating beyond the room of origin now and start to go out into down the hallway into other rooms of the house. The smoke's penetrating down there. The smoke alarm has activated after 30 seconds, so if you're upstairs, it's from 30 seconds from the time the fire started, you've now woken up to being aware something's going on in your house.
So how much of that ferocity is down to the foam?
It's almost entirely down to the foam at the moment. We're going to go in and extinguish that within about 3.5 minutes. Yeah. And you'll notice once we've done that, there'll be a lot of timber in there that's almost unburnt, won't even be charred. Almost all of what you are seeing at the moment comes down to the foam just combusting.
It's a lot of smoke and flames for 1.5 to 2 minutes in.
Yeah. And you can see now we've actually got fire extinction outside of the compartment. It's at the smoke that is travelling several metres away from a fire is now igniting. And so that is now heating up other aspects in the compartment.
So that's just when you talk about the heat release in a short amount of time, this is what you're talking about, right?
Exactly. There's virtually nothing else in your house that will release this much heat in such a short period of time. Carpets and furnishings and drapes, sure, they will burn eventually, but nothing will give you this amount of heat production.
So it's coming out now.
That room is totally unsurvivable. No one, even with protective gear in there, will survive in that room. But also down in nearby rooms and hallways and other bedrooms now, they will now be unsurvivable in a house situation. If this was downstairs, you might be upstairs in a room where you have not been overcome by the fire, but you can now no longer get downstairs. And that's what we saw in Flatbush with those three people that died.
Now, you guys are going in now, but this is pretty early in the big scheme of things, right?
Yep, so they're going in at about 3.5 minutes now. Our average attendance in New Zealand cities is around 8 minutes. So our fire engine is still 4 or 5 minutes away down the road. We're just going to put it out now so that you can see, once the fire is out, we'll go and have a look in the compartment and you'll see what has been burning, what hasn't, what has really contributed to this incredible amount of fire development.